Hello, everybody. Namaste. Welcome. Thanks for tuning in. This is going to be probably something a little bit different than what you see on the normal Icewater classes. So this is something I'm very passionate about, and it's going to be a very intense class. So let's begin. Start off with the Om. Sit up nice and tall. Close the eyes. Watch the space in the eyebrows, through the mind. You might see colors shifting lights. Watch unconcern. Imagine yourself everywhere, merging with everything, touching all of creation. Mantra for purification. This mantra will purify the ground, the air around you, your 72,000 psychic channels. You can try to copy, follow along, or just kind of listen. You'll still receive the benefits. All right, close the eyes, concentrate between the eyebrows. Om Apavitraha Yahasmarikvandrikachan. Sabahya bien traha sijihi. Om apavitraha pavitruva sarva vashtanga topiva yahasmarit vandrika chan sabahya bien traha sijihi. Om apavitraha pavitruva sarva vashtanga topiva yahasmarit vandrika chan Sabahya bien traha sikhi. Next is the Bija mantra. Again, listen. The Bija seed sound stimulates your chakras where your consciousness meets your physiology. Concentrate on the region and the color. You can listen, and if you can, follow along. Concentrate the base of the spine. Seat sound is Lam, the color red, Muladhara chakra for grounding purposes. Lam, 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 Lam. Lam, 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 Lam. Concentrate. High to the sexual organ, Swadhisthana. For creativity, the seat sound Vam, the color orange. Bam, 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 bam. Bam, 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 bam. Concentrate high to the navel. Manipura, color yellow for your will. Seat sound Ram. Ram, 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 Ram. Ram, 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 Ram. Anahata, right side of the physical heart, the color green, the seat sound Yam, for your compassion. Yam, 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 Yam. Yam, 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 Yam. Throw region for your expression. Seat sound hum, color blue. Hum, 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 hum. Hum, 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 hum. between the eyebrows, anjane, the color indigo, strengthening your sense of perception. Seats on om. Sahasrara, top of the head, color violet, two long ohms. Stand up, preparing for the exercise. So you'll come to the top of the mat. Bring your hands to the center of the chest. And do the best you can. Copy me, following along. Stretch your arms up. Arch back. And fold over the legs. Utanasana. Step the right leg back. The knee goes down. The gaze goes up. The question goes. Fantastic. Do the plank pose. The knees, the chest, the chin. Cobra pose. Squeeze the back bone. Down with this dog pose. Right foot forward, left knee down. Question pose. Fantastic. Feet together. Uttanasana. Stretch arm, upward hand. Forward body. And hands to the heart. Pranamasana. Back to normal. Here we go. Go back. Good, down. Left leg back, knee down. Plank pose. Ashtanga Namaskara, knees, chest, chin. 8-point salute. Cobra, Bhujangasana. Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Left foot forward, right knee down, look up. Feet together, top of the mat. Stretch up, arch the back. And hands to the heart. Two more. Go back. Go down. Right leg back. Plank. Knees, chest, chin. Cobra. Dog. Right foot. Left knee down. Feet together, top of the mat. Stretch up. And hands to the heart. Last round. Go back. Go down. Left leg back, plank, knees, chest, chin, cobra pose, dog pose, left foot forward, right knee down, feet together, stretch up, and hands to the heart. Close your eyes, let things come back to normal, catch your breath. King of the yogis, Shiva, Shiva Namaskara Vinyasa. Interlace your fingers, release the index finger. Stretch the arms up. Look at the heel of the hand, an extended back bend. You'll find the limit. Legs are firm, sternum lifted. Stretch up, and then back you go. Stretch up. Bend the knee, swim the arms behind the back. Clasp the knuckles, let the knuckles drift over the head. A couple of gentle bounces. Get your torso, strike the thighs. You can sway a little bit, get into the low back, the shoulders. Good, arms dangle back down. Look up halfway, choices. Either step back plank pose, lower down Chaturanga Dandasana, upward dog. Downward dog, or Bakasana, knees on the backs of the arms. If you know how to go upside down, you can go upside down, tripod headstand, or press it up into the handstand. If
You go upside down, go back to the crow, shoot the legs back, Chaturanga Dandasana, Urdhva Mukha, upward dog, downward dog. Get the head close to the floor. From here, stretch your left leg up, left foot between the hands. Right knee comes down. Stretch the arms up, Kapyasana.
Wiggle the shoulders, like me. Lift the sternum. Good, once you find the limit, you can relax the head back.
And come up, left hand down, right arm up. Easy triangle, you can lift out of the hips a little bit. And if you can bind, bind. If you're flexible, no condition in the knee, you can turn the right foot in and try to grab the foot for a quad stretch. Then take the full bind. Breathing. Slowly release. You'll return to the previous pose. Kapyasana. See if you can go a little bit deeper and tuck the back toes. So lift through the sternum, pull the arms back.
Wiggle the shoulders.
Release the head back. If the foot is close, grab the foot. And come up, hands to the heart. The left foot comes back. You're gonna turn twist the right elbow outside the left knee. Pelvis stays level, breathing. Abdomen tone. If you can bind, armpit towards the knee. Push past the thigh, the abdomen. Hold your left wrist, fingers, clothing. You stay here. You can straighten the back leg. You can parallel the feet. Slowly release. Same way you come in. You come out, plank pose, and you'll do a sidearm balance on the left side, Vashistasana. But you'll do it different. The left foot will be flat, right foot behind the left foot like a rock star. Lock up the leg, the pelvis. You might grab the knee. If you can, the heel. Very flexible. You can flip the grip.
Put your foot on the head, bird drinking pose. Kapinjalasana.
Plank pose. You'll switch the sides. Foot is flat, angle the toes, lock up the leg, the pelvis, knee. Heel, you can dip the hip.
Or bird drinking pose. Kapinjalasana.
Plank pose. You can do knees, chest, chin. Cobra pose.
Dog pose.
Stand up pose, head close to the floor. Triceps back. Inner thigh spinning up and back. Long spine, stretching the shoulders. Keep that protraction, or you put your elbows down and then you may split the legs. You can come into a pincha.
Maybe a hollow back, stretch your shoulders. Push into the elbows.
Downward dog. Right leg up. The right foot through between your hands. Left knee down.
Go back, Kapyasana. Wiggle the shoulders.
Good down. The right hand down. Left arm up. If you can bind, bind. Turn your chest to the sky. You stay here. You can turn the left heel in towards the right seat. Careful the knee. And grab the foot. And you bind. Grabbing your left wrist. Quad stretch. Easy triangle. Pubic bone navel. Point your chest to the sky. Release that. And then you're going to return to the previous pose. You can tuck the back toes. Bring the ankle closer to your hands. Lift up through the sternum. Go back. You can grab the foot. Come up. Hands to the heart. You can hop your right foot back. Bring it to the right. Angle the toes. Lift your chest. Don't let your knees sickle in. Turn, twist. And then if you have the bind, hold. Turn. Pull the top arm straight. Point your chest to the sky. Breathing. You can straighten the back leg. You can parallel the feet, keeping the bind. Turn. You'll unwind. Same way you come in, same way you come out. You come to the plank pose. On the right side, Vashistasana. Other side, on the left side. Angry determination. Lock out the leg, the pelvis. Here, dip the hip, here, lift the hip.
Or bird drinking pose. Big toe side.
Plank. The knees, the chest, the chin.
Cobra pose.
Downward facing dog pose. Again, stay here for a second chance to balance on the forearms. Put your elbows down, most of the weight in the elbows. Here, stretch the leg. Push and split the legs. If you land, you can fall on one side and then jump to the other side. Downward facing dog. Left foot forward. Spin the right heel down. First warrior. Sit nice and low. And lift the sternum. Low ribs in, and then interlace the fingers behind, lift your chest, bring your torso towards your thigh. Come on the ball of the right foot, Pattan Vrikshasana, balance on the right leg, toppling tree. And keep a bend in the left knee. If you can, you can release the clasp. Standing split, Urdhva Prasrita Ekta Padasana. You see the inseam of the right leg. You can walk the hands back. If you know how to do a handstand, put your hands down. Handstand. Step back. Second warrior.
So sit nice and low, as low as you can sit. Always try to take on the consciousness of the pose. Warrior pose. Sit a little bit lower. 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 Now straight the front leg. Turn the toes in. Parallel the feet. Stretch the arms up. Down you go.
You can take the tripod headstand, fingertips face back, or any variation. So look at my fingers, tent them, Tadasana Bandha. Shift the weight forward, raise the legs. If you're comfortable, pinky finger, ring finger, middle finger, lose the thumb. Open up the legs, careful. Look up halfway. You'll spin around towards the front of the room or front of your mat, rock forward, rock back. Prepare for the lizard. You'll bring the right elbow down, the left elbow down. You can glue the knee to the shoulder, upper spine straight, feel a little bit more flexible. This is a variation. Sinking, hold chest down. If you know the bind, arms will come to a T. You might be able to bind. No gap between left shin and ribcage. Slowly exiting the pose. You can take the flying lizard, Kundinyasana, or tuck the back toes, armpit around the knee like Marichasana. One-legged crow here, shift, and then to the Kundinyasana. Chin stand, Gandhubhardasana if you have this. Drop the chest. Upward dog, downward dog. The right leg up, right foot through between your hands, left heel comes down. Come up first, warrior. Interlace the fingers at the base of the spine. Lift your chest, bring your torso over the right thigh. Prepare for toppling tree, Pattan Bhikshasana. On the ball of the left foot, spring forward. Point the left toes. Standing split, Urdhva Prasrirekta Padasana.
Reach to the inseam, square off, right hand. You can play with the balance, left hand, or handstand.
Second warrior. Land the toes light behind you. Spin the heel down. Come up. Sitting nice and low. Sit as low as you can. Lift up the hip points. Root down to the baby right toe. Don't let the knee sickle in. Partial drishti. Look past shoulder. Reforming left arch. Lower ribs in. Sit lower. Lower. Lower, straight the leg, turn the feet in, heel ball the feet in,
Now, depending on your practice, you can put the hands to support the low back, like so. You find your limit. You can come here. Maybe down to the calves. If you're very flexible, the feet come in, and you do a drop back. So the arms up, come into the wheel. The only way you come all the way down is if you can stand back up. Come to the center. I'm gonna turn around for you guys. Now you go down. So, from here, fold and grab the toes, you stay here. And then those of you that have a handstand, you can press up, straddle up. And if you can, handstand scorpion. So shoulders forward on the balls of the feet, here, here. Come down. Trying to move slow. From here, you'll spin around. Prepare for the lizard. Rock forward, rock back. Left elbow, right elbow down. Knee, shoulder, stay here. You can come all the way down. Wrap your armpit around the front ankle, shin. Glue the shin to the ribcage, slide the left hand back, start to sink. If you can bind a little loop, hold. You'll come out. You're gonna turn around so you can kind of see this side. Oh, well, we already saw that side. So I'm not gonna turn around. So you can wrap the armpit around the knee, slide the hand back, you'll tuck the back toes. This can be it. Shift forward here. Kundi. Gandhi Bandhasana. Upward dog, downward dog. Left foot between the hands, right knee on the floor. Split pose. Keep a bend in the left knee. Hanumanasana. Can work like this. Put the blocks underneath the hands or underneath the hamstring. Gently. Slide the foot forward. Stretch the arms up. You can use the left hand to support you. Reach around, lean back. Find the foot. And then once you go back, you can go down. Square off. You can twist. This will help you square off. Here. You have the over splits, tuck the back toes, grab your left Achilles, you can sink. From here, the pigeon pose, lean to the left, you'll bend your left knee, lift your chest, down you go. If you're a little bit more flexible, get your foot nice and high.
You can turn, twist, get your shoulder inside. Come up, push the floor away, downward facing dog. Right foot forward, left knee on the floor, and slowly start to gently work towards split pose, Hanumanasana. Keep the sole of the foot flat so you don't agitate the hamstring. Little by little. Square off. You can turn the body, leaning back as best you can. Grab the foot, use the right hand as support. Draw all the way down. You can come down. Twisting will help you square off. If you have the over splits, tuck the back toes. Gentle bounces. And slowly, pigeon pose on the right. Square off with your chest. And down you go. If you're a little bit more flexible, foot a little bit higher. And slowly come out, downward dog. Put your knees on the floor. Sit between the heels. You can sit on the block. Don't let the knees go wider than the hips. If you can, keep them together. If you're comfortable, Supta Virasana, recline down. Relax. Stretch your ankles, your knees, your thighs. Slowly push the floor away. Right elbow, right hand, left elbow, left hand. I'm going to face you. Lift your seat, free the right leg. Slide the right sole of the foot in. Stay here, turn, twist. If it agitates your left knee, you sit on the block. Or take the half lotus. Heel groin, blade of the foot, hip crease. Bow over the right leg. Arch the back, create space in the low back. Hoof, find the foot. Turn, twist. Helix the spine. Slowly unwind. Free both legs. Give your knees a quick little massage. And then you'll lean to the left. You'll bend the right knee. Again, you can always sit on a block. You can just keep the sole of the foot inside the right thigh. You can turn, twist like so. Or you bring the heel close to the groin, lay to the foot, hip crease. You can bow over the left leg, create space in the low back. And then grab the foot, turn, twist. Slowly unwind. You may give your knees a quick massage. And then the next is king of the poses, the headstand. So your goal is to hold onto your headstand and stay there and close the eye for meditation. If you can tie a lotus, you tie a lotus. You have to stay there. If you can, stay as long as me. Okay? And I'll show you. You can watch me before you kind of get into it. Can you use a wall? Put your fingers down, interlace, loose basket, back of the skull here. You'll tuck the toes, you'll walk your toes in. Here, 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 here. If you're flexible, one leg at a time. If you're very strong, two legs, same time, pike. Stay here, eyes closed, meditation. If you have a lotus, it becomes powerful. Becomes a mudra, a seal. Right foot in, left leg back. Get the heel towards the groin. And you can wiggle it. Sitting on the ceiling, you'll get the lotus nice and tight. And then you stay. Eyes closed, meditation time. Be still, almost like you're falling down backwards. You can imagine a violet lotus flower. The space behind the forehead. If you come out, try to come back in. If you are a little bit stronger, your neck's higher, knees back. Free the hands, palms flat. Push into the elbows. Lift your head. Relax the neck. Head back down. Unlotus. Come down slow. Child's pose. Keep your head down. Always let everything come back to normal. So the next is shoulder stand. After the compression in cervical neck spine, after headstand is shoulder stand, stretching cervical neck spine, stimulating thyroid gland. If you have a shirt, loose shirt, you tuck it in so you don't get hockey jersey. You can lean to one side, get your legs out in front, or you can come to the downward dog. You do not move the hands. The arms are strong, neck is strong. No straining, chin in, elbows to the side. Back of the skull, shoulders. Touch your back. One straight line, toes to the chin. You stay here. Or if you have a lotus, you may tie the lotus. You may use the left hand. If you have a strong core, balance. Stay here. Remain still. Do not move. Close the eyes. Meditation time.
If you are not in the lotus, you can bring your knees to your ears for ear pressure pose. If you have the lotus, keep the lotus, Karnapindyasana, embryo pose. You can wrap your forearms around the calf muscles or get the lotus tied. If you have the lotus, keep the lotus. Rolling the spine down. If you are not in the lotus, extend the legs, point the toes. Top of the head on the floor. Chest is the highest point. The fish pose, Matsyasana. Now, if you have the lotus, you can put your hands by the ears. Get more at the top of the head. Grab the feet. Pull the lotus tighter. Eventually, the elbows touching. Tip of the nose striking the earth, trying to keep the top of the head on the floor. If you have a lotus, you may have a lotus, easy. Uddhanapadasana, flying fish, Bhastrika, breathe fast, the nose like a sniffing dog. Slowly, chin in, relax for two long breaths. Shavasana for two long breaths. Pretending like you can go to sleep. From here, rocking chair, throw the legs back. And rock forward, back, forward, back, forward, last one, back, forward, come up. From here, bend your knees, come into the squatting pose. So if you are a little bit newer, something's going on, half firefly here. Turn. Okay. If you know the full pose, Tiddhasana. So just work the right side. I'll let you know when to change, full pose. Shoulders behind the knees, sit down, have to hold higher on the spine. Open up the legs, here. If you're doing the right side, switch the sides. Come back to the squatting pose. From here, firefly. You can lift your seat. You can put your hands on the blocks. Put your fingers behind the heels. Sit on the back of the arm. One leg, other leg. The crow pose, shift the shoulders forward. Legs back. Shoot the legs back. Upward dog. Downward dog. Head close to the floor. From here, if you can, jump your legs through the hands. Scoot your seat forward. Prepare for the bridge pose. Tickle the heels with the piece on the next finger. Lift your hips up. Interlace the fingers, roll onto the outer triceps. Hips nice and high. Slowly lower upper back, middle back, lower back down. Same. Turning into tiptoe couch pose. So, hips up, interlace, roll onto the other triceps. And then free the clasp, support sacral area. Careful the knees, walk your toes in. You can drop your knees, top of the head on the floor. Hands by the ears. Come up into the wheel pose, Urdhva Dhanurasana. You can come up on the toes, rock your chest forward and back. And slowly you come down, chin in, upper back, middle back, lower back. Take a breath, recovery. Okay. Again, the wheel pose. If you know how to stand up, you may stand up. If it's too much, you can repeat the bridge pose. Hands by the ears. Place the top of the head on the floor. Raise your heads. Walk your hands in. Come up. And then you go back. And slowly you come down. You can bring your knees to your chest, a little squeeze. You can scoot your seat forward. You can come into halasana. Stretch your back. Too much, knees on the forehead. If you know the backward somersault, you keep your toes tucked. Put your hands by your ears. Push. Roll over the top of the head. Lower down. Meet me on the abdomen. Thumbs towards the low ribs. Open up the legs a little bit. Pubic bone pressing down. Inhaling. Cobra, King Cobra. Squeeze the back muscles. Lengthen to the crown. Head into the cradle shoulder. Bend your knees, big toe snatch. Slowly come down. Make a little pillow.
Two long breaths. Pretending you can breathe through every cell here upon your body. Breathing out through the skin. Breathing in. Breathing out.
Okay, again, hands in position. You can tent the fingertips for more leverage if you need. Pubic bone presses down.
Inhaling a little bit and slowly come up.
Retraction in between the shoulder blade scapula. Pull the shoulders down. Lengthen through the crown of the head. Keeping that leg. Head into the cradle of the shoulder. Bend the knee. And calm down.
Two long breaths, breathing in the best prana energy, breathing out, breathing in, breathing out.
Repeat previous, but cobras do not have arms, so maybe don't use the arms. You can slide the hands back. But once your spine's very strong, no arms. All right. So
So from here, you can bring the arms forward, or you're gonna repeat the previous. The arms, the chest come up, press the pubic bone down, strong torso. Inhaling, up you go.
Arms back, go for the knees, bend the knees. Slowly come.
Make a little pillow. Two long breaths. Okay, the bow pose. So you can do traditional here.
And keep the knees in, weight forward. Stay here.
Head back, look for the toes. Then you can soften a little bit, flex the foot. Right, big toe side, flex the left foot, big toe side. You can bring your feet to your head, get a better grip. This is the full pose. And then the legs up. Head, if you can, shoulders. Nice and slow. You may exit the pose.
Press back, child's pose,
knees apart.
Give your back a little massage.
Slowly come up.
Okay. So we'll try two variations, pinch a scorpion and maybe a handstand scorpion. So now to kind of enjoy the fruits of our efforts. So you put your elbows down and I'll show you where it's going to go from here, depending on where you're at, what you get. And it might not happen, it might happen. So, and you can just work on finding the balance. Land your elbows down. Okay, and then you walk your toes in, your eyes will point. You just kick up, use your bottom leg. Try to tip up, actually. Find a line, push, and then toes, chin together. Keep the knees as best you can together. Bend the knees. Stay here. Very flexible. Put your toes hard, chin in. Lengthen, flex your feet. Get your feet on your back. Ease in. Stretch your shoulders. You can jump to the other side. Usually that's what happens. So you can play around with that. We'll try the handstand one. Sometimes better on the flatter surface. And you can always walk your toes on the wall. But the back's pretty warmed up. So try to move slow. See if I can adjust this mic. So you land your hands here. Let's try the other leg for balance. Shoulders forward, you tip, try not to jump too much, move nice and slow. Concentrate, slowly bring the legs together. Toes, chin, move together. Lastly, the knees. That's the best way to fall. You fall, you can try to stand back up. You can try again. Any kind of variation that you want to do. You don't have to do a handstand scorpion. You don't have to do a forearm stand scorpion. Those are some things to do. You can work on a camel pose, anything that you want. So you're at home, anything that you want to work on, specialty time. Yeah, let's try one more, maybe on the flatter surface, because the mat's a little bit cushiony, so you lose your balance and move. Here, here, try the other leg, here. Get your extension, legs are strong,
Same knees. Chin in. Moving nice and slow, never flinging out of the back bend. Okay, so now that you had your fix, legs out in front, star pose, I'll face you, Tadasana. This is nice and mild before we work into Paschimottanasana, before a bend, just to kind of round and relax everything down opposite direction. So wide base, heel away from the groin, so it's a diamond shape. Kali Mudra grip, release the index finger, open up the heel of the hand, grab the toes, slide the elbows forward, the elbows, the four points of the star, the fingers, the fifth point. So from above, the five-pointed star. Relax your back. Slowly come up, gather the knees in, extend the legs. You can keep a bend in the knees. Lift your sternum, sternum.
Concentrate any stress points, the base of the spine. The color is red. And slowly come up.
Now, easy twist, cross your right ankle below, outside your left knee. Tense your right fingertips, left arm up, turn, twist. Look past the shoulder. Parasudristhi. Concentrate, ascending colon. Imagine the energy spiraling from the base of the spine, top of the head, the prana, upward energy. Switch the direction to other side. And slowly unwind. Prepare to relax on your back. Shavasana. Relax completely. Leave your body by itself. Breath by itself. But your attention's like a magnet. Where your attention goes, prana follows, healing forces. So bring your attention to your left toes. Loose and tingling. Foot. Ankle, calf, knee, upper leg and thigh. Totally relaxed now. Leaving your left leg by itself. Right toes. Loose. Foot. Ankle, calf,
upper leg and thigh. Sinking. Left fingers relax. Hand, wrist, forearm, upper arm and shoulder, heavy, left arm totally relaxed now. Right fingers loose and tingling. Hand. Wrist. Forearm. Upper arm and shoulder, sinking. Right arm totally relaxed now. Hips heavy. Pelvic region sinking from the waist down, dead like. Lower back, middle back, upper back, heavy. Feel your total spine sinking. Abdomen relaxed. Chest loose. Throat open. Lips, jaw loose. Cheeks relax, ear relax, eyes heavy, forehead smooth, scalp tingling. Using all body sensations. And slowly prepare to come out. Wiggle the fingers, your toes. Twirl the ankles, wrists. Rock your head side to side. Deepening your breath. Consciousness, life, awareness, shifting back in. Any stretch you know along the way. You may roll onto one side of the body, bending your knees, use your bicep as a pillow. And then push the floor away. Come up towards a comfortable meditative seat. Tall spine, the eyes closed. And keep the attention at the space between the eyebrows, seat of the mind. Sound meditation. Keep watching the space between the eyebrows. I'm gonna ring a bowl. When the sound dissipates, try to repeat the sound mentally. Nar Dayana, sound meditation. Sitting up nice and tall, concentrate. Receptive. Namaste.